What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, when I came across this video of Kat Von D, Queen of the Darkness, giving her first interview since her public baptism, I felt like I had to share this clip with my audience. Why? Because it raised some questions in my mind. I love and appreciate the fact that Kat has given her life to Christ. By her own admission, she said she's not a baby Christian. This is something that has been a transformational process in her life for some time, and she just now made it public with her baptism ceremony. But it's something that she has committed herself to for some time now, which is great. But this clip raised some questions in my mind. The song Changed by Tremaine Hawkins comes to mind. When you give your life to Christ, you have a new outlook, you have a new heart, you have a new walk, you have a new talk, you have a new outward expression. You can walk into a room and people say, you have a glow about you. Something has changed since you've given your life to Christ. And when I look at Kat Von D, I hear the words out of her mouth, and then I look at her outward expression. It doesn't seem like it's changed at all, which raises questions. But I'll let you decide. Let's get into this interview from the Ali Beth Stuckey podcast and see how you feel about Kat Von D expressing the fact that she has thrown some things in her old life away and made a change. Let's go.
So now I'm going to fast forward to like the first post that I ever made about talking about like throwing away my occult books.
Yes.
Yeah. And I think that everybody kind of honed in, my fans included, on the witchcraft books, because there was a lot more of those than there was the others. But I actually threw away all my meditation books, all my books on yoga, all my like, it wasn't just the stuff that people considered spooky, which, you know, I don't think some of it is, but and I think that it's easier to look at like a story, like what I wrote, and mind you, I prayed a lot about that post prior to doing it. Like I spent time on writing that caption because I knew the intentions behind it were to like start being able to talk about where I'm at in life, you know.
And that was what, 2020?
Yeah.
Or so?
I think so, yeah. And it was such an, so I posted this post on Instagram where I just took a picture of a good chunk of these books that I took from my library. I have a library of like 300 to 500 books. And so this was a very small, like a small amount of books out of that collection that I just wanted to get rid of. Like I don't want to say that they were haunting me, but it's like, I already knew they were there. I have my son who's growing up and is becoming curious. And it's like, you know, there were some art books I threw away too that weren't in that picture that were like, I don't know if I want my kid to look at that, you know?
Yeah.
Like, but to me it was like I came to this really awesome realization that night that I decided to post that, was that like I don't want these crutches in my life anymore. You know, and that's what I really saw them as, is like, okay, like I just want Jesus. And it's a narrow road, right? Like I feel like all these other, like these breathing techniques or these or like spell work or whatever, like nature worship, all these things, it's like they're just crutches. They're not really like my answer.
Yeah.
And so for me, I would rather eliminate any distractions, and this is just for what works for me, you know. So that was like, it was a symbolic gesture, I guess, in a way, but it was my first like proclaiming of where I stand with certain things. And it was crazy to watch the reaction, because in the comments it was like, I feel like you could see literal demons hissing at each other. And it was coming from both sides, you know, from people that were like, oh, I don't think Aleister Crowley's evil, or hey, like, why would you throw this away? You should give them to people, like, that's so wasteful or whatever. Or there's nothing wrong with what I see in these pictures. And then there would be the Christians that are like attacking and kind of saying equally as evil things too, you know, that weren't helping anybody.
Mm.
And that night, I feel like two people came to my house. So at the time we lived in LA and we had a gated house, And I was upstairs with my son, and the doorbell rang, and we had like a security system. And my husband looks, and it was, he screenshotted it, and it was just this possessed person, you know, who just was like, hi, you know, I don't want to freak you out, but I just want to know if I could please have those books, you know, like I really need those books. I need those books. And it was just like, and you could see the darkness in this eye, and like, like why I think, like when I say things, cause I definitely think that people over
spiritualize.
No, like, I just think a lot of people, especially in the Christian community, like call everything demonic, and I don't think everything is demonic. Yeah. Like, but in this case, I was like, I think this is a definition of a demon. Like this person is possessed and is no longer in control of what they would normally do, because A, they're obsessed either with fame or with the desire to bring certain evils into your life, you know? I think that's crazy. You know, my husband ushered him away. Then the second person came and they tried to break into our trash cans.
Wow.
Which I had
to
already thrown.
To get the books.
Huh?
To get the books.
Yeah. Yeah. Which were all readily available online anyway. I mean, I did have like first editions of stuff, but like, but it's like, what is it in you that's like so desperate for, you know, like, again, trying to find these answers in the wrong places, a literal trash can.
What do you think about that segment, y'all? Kat Von D saying that she has dedicated her life to Christ. And once she announced it publicly, people who followed her in that gothic lifestyle were annoyed, were offended, were angered that she decided to leave that lifestyle and follow Christ. They attacked her to the point of coming to her home. And she felt like at that point, these were demons, people possessed with demons who were attacking her at her home. But when we look at Kat Von D, we don't see any change in the appearance. But my question to you is, how important is appearance? She's still dressed in all black with the all black hair and the powdery white makeup with the winged eyeliner and the bright red lips. This is the goth look. The only thing that I see that has changed is the cross, gold cross around her neck. On top of the all black, on top of the gothic. How important is it to change your appearance when you change your lifestyle and dedicate yourself to Christ? At another point in the interview, she said she wasn't going to change her circle of friends. She admitted that a lot of folks that she saw in that gothic lifestyle that were into witchcraft and the demonic were just broke, needing something to cling on to because they didn't have anything in this natural life. But she stated that she wasn't going to change her circle of friends. Now, is it possible, y'all, that God could use her as a tool in the gothic community to bring folks to him? Could Kat Von D be on assignment, y'all? I need you to let me know in the comments, because I'm not so sure as I look at this. And as you go into the interview, I suggest you all take a look at the full interview. It seems like Kat Von D is talking right. Seems like she's on the right path. She says out of her own mouth, I'm not a baby Christian. Don't try to put that on me like I don't know nothing about this. I've been about this Jesus lifestyle for a minute. I just haven't told y'all. I just haven't expressed it outright to y'all. Well, how do you feel about that? It makes me question the whole circumstance. How do you change your life? How do you go in a new direction and keep it a secret? How is it that none of your millions of demonic followers, gothic followers, not know? They follow you. They follow your blogs. They follow your tweets. They follow everything you do. And they never noticed a change. until you said so. How do y'all feel about this? Let me know in the comments, because this is an interesting study in a spiritual transformation. And I want to know what you think. Y'all like the video? Subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.